Chapter 10, Measuring a Nation's Income. We seek answers to the following questions. What is gross domestic product, or GDP? How is GDP related to a nation's total income and spending? What are the components of GDP? How is GDP corrected for inflation? Does GDP measure society's well-being? Economics has two branches. One is microeconomics, a study of how households and farms make decisions and how they interact in markets. The other is macroeconomics, a study of economy-wide phenomena, including inflation, unemployment, and economic growth. Income and expenditure. Gross domestic product, or GDP, measures total income of everyone in the economy. Also measures total expenditure on the economy's output of goods and services. And therefore, income equals expenditure for the economy as a whole, because every dollar a buyer spends is a dollar of income for the seller. Active Learning 1. Income equals expenditure. Nala pays James $50 to mow her lawn. Number A. What happens with total expenditure? What happens with total income? James is a seller of a service and Nala is a buyer. James earns $50 and Nala spends $50. Total expenditure rises by $50. Total income rises by $50. The circular flow. The circular flow diagram is a simple depiction of the macroeconomy. It illustrates GDP as spending, revenue, factor payments, and income. Preliminaries. Factors of production are inputs like labor, land, capital, and natural resources. Factor payments, payments to factors of production, for example, wages and rent. Circular flow diagram includes two major institutions in our economy, households and business firms. Households own factors of production, sell or rent them to firms for income. They also buy and consume goods and services produced by business firms. Business firms, on the other hand, buy or hire factors of production, use them to produce goods and services, and sell these goods and services to the household. Their interaction is primarily through two kinds of markets. One is called markets for factors of production, where households take resources of land and labor and capital for onward transmission to the business firm. The business firm will turn around and pay for these resources. So business spends wages, rent, and profit, and households receive that as income. That is GDP, spending by business firms, income by households. The other market they interact in is the goods market. Market for goods and services. Households spend their income on goods and services. Businesses, business firms receive this income and exchange it for goods and services that they produce. There is the circular flow diagram. What this diagram omits. The government We know that government collects taxes and buys goods and services, but government is a big part of our economy. It emits financial system, which deals with matching savers' supply of funds with borrowers' demand for loans. It emits the foreign sector, which trades goods and services, financial assets, and currencies with the country's residents. So what is gross domestic product? Is the market value highlighted of all final goods and services produced within a country in a given year. Market value emphasized means goods are valued at their market prices. So all goods measured in the same unit, for example, dollars in the United States. Things that don't have a market value are excluded. For example, housework you do for yourself. Of all highlighted, what does that mean? GDP includes all items produced in the economy and sold legally in the markets. GDP excludes most items produced and sold illicitly. It also excludes most items that are produced and consumed at home. Final is emphasized. What does that mean? Final goods, intended goods that are intended for the end user. We exclude intermediate goods. These are goods used as components or ingredients in the production of other goods. So GDP only includes final goods. They already embody the value of the intermediate goods used in their production. Goods and services highlighted. What does that mean? Goods include tangible goods like food, mountain bikes, beer, and intangible services like dry cleaning, concerts, haircuts. Produced is highlighted. What does that mean? GDP includes currently produced goods, not goods produced in the past. Within a country, highlighted. What does that mean? GDP measures the value of production that occurs within a country's borders, whether done by its own citizens or by foreigners located there. In a given period of time, what does that mean? Usually a year or a quarter, 3 months. So let's look at active learning two. What is included in GDP? Nala pays James $50 to mow her lawn. Number A, what happens with GDP? Number B, will your answer to the previous question change if Nala and James get married? Number A, when Nala pays $50 to mow her lawn, that transaction is part of GDP. Number B, if James and Nala get married and James continues to mow Nala's lawn, the value of the mowing is now left out of GDP because James' service is no longer sold in market. The components of GDP. Recall, GDP is total spending. There are four components. One, consumption, or C, investment, or I, government purchases, or G, net exports, NX. These components add up to GDP, which is denoted by Y. So Y is equal to C plus I plus G plus X. Let's take them one by one. Consumption, or C, is total spending by households on goods and services. Does not include purchases of new housing. It's a note on housing costs. For renters, C includes rent payments. For homeowners, C includes the imputed rental value of the house, but not the purchase price or mortgage payment. Investment, or I, this is total spending on goods that will be used in the future to produce more goods. Business capital, that's business structures, equipment, and intellectual property products. Residential capital, landlord's apartment buildings, a homeowner's personal residence, and inventory, accumulation of goods produced but not yet sold. Investment does not mean the purchase of financial assets like stocks and bonds. Government purchases, or G. Government purchases are all spending on the goods and services purchased by the government, all the federal, state, and local levels. It excludes transfer payments, such as Social Security or unemployment insurance. They are not purchases of goods and services. Net exports. Net exports, or NX, equals exports minus imports. Exports are foreign spending on the economy's goods and services. Imports are the portions of consumption, investment, and government that are spent on goods and services produced abroad. Adding up all the components of GDP gives Y equals C plus I plus G plus NX. US GDP and its components in 2018. Y is the GDP, and in 2018 is $20,494 billion, or you would say trillions. And of that, 68.1% was consumption. Consumption was $13,948 billion. That is 68.1% of GDP. Investment spending was $3,650 billion, and that is 17.8% of GDP. Government spending was $3,521 billion, and that is 17.2% of GDP. And net export is negative 625, which is negative 3% of GDP. Negative just means that we run a trade deficit. And the last column is a per capita or a per person basis. GDP, if you take $20,494 billion, divide it by the population of the United States, this would be called GDP per capita, and consumption per capita, and investment per capita, and government spending per capita, and net exports per capita. Active learning 3, GDP and its components. What is the effect on GDP and its component? Number A, Jezara spent $300 to buy her husband dinner at the finest restaurant in Boston. Number B, Nyla spends $1,200 on a new smartphone to use in her publishing business. The smartphone was built in China. Number C, Joseph spends $800 on a tablet to use in his editing business. He got last year's model on sale for a great price from a local manufacturer. Number D, GM builds $500 million worth of cars, but consumers only buy $470 million worth of them. Answers. Number A, Jezara spent $300 to buy her husband dinner at the finest restaurant in Boston. Answer. Consumption rises by 300, GDP rises by 300. Nyla spends $1,200 on a new smartphone to use in her publishing business. The smartphone was built in China. Here, investment rises by $1,200. Net export falls by $1,200 because imports rise by $1,200 and GDP remains unchanged. Number C, Joseph spends $800 on a tablet to use in his editing business. He got last year's model on sale for a great price from a local manufacturer. Answer, investment and GDP remain unchanged. Joseph's business, investment in Joseph's business rises by 800 and inventories fall by 800. And number D, General Motors builds $500 million worth of cars, but consumers only buy 470 million of them. And the answer, consumption rises by 400 million and inventory rises by 30 million and GDP rises by 500 million. Real versus nominal GDP. Nominal GDP values output using current prices, not and is not corrected for inflation. Real GDP values output using the prices of a base year and is corrected for inflation. For the base year, nominal GDP is always equal to real GDP. Example 1A, calculating nominal GDP. In this hypothetical economy, in year 2019, they produced 300 pizzas at the pizza price was $15 and 1,000 chocolate and the price was $2.50 and the following data for 2020 and 2021. How do we calculate the nominal GDP? That is valuing output using current prices. So for 2019 was 300 times 15 plus 1,000 times $2.50, and that is how you get that 7,000. For 2020, you take 400, multiply by 16, add that to 1,200, multiply by 3, and that is how you get $10,000. For 2021, you take 500, multiply by 17, plus 1,300 multiply by 350, and that is how you get 1,350. And if you calculate the percentage increase year to year from 2019 to 2020, nominal GDP increased by 42.9%. And between 2020 and 2021, nominal GDP increased by 30.5%. What about real GDP? Compute real GDP in each year, and the base year is given as 2019. What that means is that we hold prices constant at 2019 prices, where pizza is $15 and chocolate is $2.50. So what is nominal GDP in 2019? It's 300 times 15 plus 1,000 times $2.50, and that is 7,000. Remember that in the base year, nominal GDP is equal to real GDP. So this 7,000 was also nominal GDP in 2019. 2020, we produced 400 pizzas, but we value them not at 16, but at $15. So 400 times 15 plus 1,200 times $2.50, and that is how we get 9,000. For year 2021, we produce 500 pizzas, we'll value it at $15, not $17. So it is 500 times 15, plus 1,300 times $2.50, and that is how we get 10,750. percentage increase over the year 2019-2020, real GDP increased by 28.6%. And over 2020 and 2021, real GDP increased by 19.4%. Example C, correcting for inflation. The change in nominal GDP reflects both prices and quantities. So that is why nominal GDP increasing from 42.9% over 2019-2020 and 30.5% over 2020-2021 is not exactly a very reliable figure. Okay, the change in nominal GDP reflects both price changes and quantity changes. A more reliable change would be calculating the real exchange rate. The change in real GDP is the amount that GDP would change if prices were constant. We hold prices zero, no inflation. And when you do that, you find that real GDP has increased by 28.6% between 2019 and 2020, and GDP has increased by 19.4% between 2020 and 2021. Hence, the real GDP is corrected for inflation, a more reliable figure. GDP deflator. GDP deflator is calculated as the ratio of nominal GDP to real GDP, multiply that by 100. That's a measure of the price level. GDP deflator measures the current level of prices relative to the level of prices in the base year. That is the economy's inflation rate. We compute the percentage increase in the GDP deflator from 1 year to the next. The formula is inflation rate. This is economy-wide inflation rate. Inflation rate in year two is equal to GDP deflator in year two minus GDP deflator in year one divided by GDP deflator in year one times 100. Example D, calculate the GDP deflator. Compute the GDP deflator in each year. Remember, GDP deflator is nominal GDP divided by real GDP times 100. So in 2019, nominal GDP was 7,000, real GDP 7,000, you multiply by 100. GDP deflator was 100. What about 2020? 10,000 is the nominal GDP, divided by 9,000, which is real GDP, you multiply by 100. GDP deflator is 111.1. What about 2021? Nominal GDP, which is 13,050, divide by real GDP, which is 10,750, you multiply that by 100 and you get 121.4. And that is what goes in this column, GDP deflator. And this is what we use to calculate the inflation rate, which is percentage change between these two numbers. From 2019 to 2020, the economy-wide inflation rate was 11.1. And between 2020 and 2021, it was 9.3%. Active learning 4, computing GDP. In this hypothetical economy, we are producing cookies and smartphones, and we are looking at 3 years, 2019, 2020, and 2021. Use the above data to solve these problems. Compute nominal GDP in 2019. Number B, compute real GDP in 2020. Number C, compute the real GDP deflator in 2021. All right, let's look at number A. Number A, compute nominal GDP, that is valuing GDP using current prices. So 2019, 900 times the dollar plus 185 times 900, you get 167,400. Number B, compute real GDP in year 2020. And we are given that 2019 is the base year. That means we use 2019 prices to value production in 2020. That means 1,000 times 1 plus 200 times 900. That is how you get 181,000. Number C, we do it in three steps. We are asked to compute GDP deflator in 2021. That means we will need nominal GDP and real GDP. So what is nominal GDP for 2021? That is 1250 times 3 plus 210 times 1200. And that is what you get here, 255,750. Real GDP, on the other hand, we value the same production year 2021 using year 2019 prices. And that is 1250 times 1 plus 210 times 900, and we get 190,250. Now, the next step is calculating the GDP deflator, which is nominal GDP divided by real GDP. That's the formula for GDP deflator. And you multiply the result by 100. So what is nominal GDP? 255,750 divided by real GDP, 190,250, and you divide, multiply that by 100, and GDP deflator is 134.4. GDP and economic well-being. Real GDP per capita. This is the main indicator of the average person's standard of living. But GDP is not a perfect measure of well-being. Robert Kennedy used a very eloquent yet harsh criticism of GDP. Senator Robert Kennedy in 1968 said, "Gross domestic product does not allow for the health of our children, the quality of their education, or the joy of their play. It does not include the beauty of our poetry or the strength of our marriages, the intelligence of our public debate or the integrity of our public officials. It measures neither our courage nor our wisdom nor our devotion to our country. It measures everything, in short, except that which makes life worthwhile, and it can tell us everything about America, except why we are proud that we are Americans." GDP does not value the quality of the environment. GDP ignores leisure time, and GDP excludes non-market activity, such as childcare a parent provides at home, volunteer work, and GDP excludes equitable distribution of income. GDP is a good measure of economic well-being for most, but not all, purposes. Now then, why do we care about GDP with all these limitations? Having a large GDP enables a country to afford better schools, a cleaner environment, healthcare, and etc., etc. many indicators of the quality of life are positively correlated with GDP. For example, GDP and life expectancy in 12 countries. It appears that countries with high GDP, Japan, Germany, United States, have higher life expectancy. People live on the average 75, 80, 85 years. And people in poorer countries live much shorter lives. GDP and average schooling in 12 countries. Again, countries with higher GDP, Germany, Japan, United States, have higher average years of schooling than GDP, than countries with less GDP. What about GDP and overall life satisfaction in these same 12 countries? People, countries with high GDP, their citizens tend to report that they're happy with their life, they're more satisfied with their life than people who live in poorer countries. Think, pair, and share. You are watching a news report with your father. It states that a certain troubled Caribbean nation generates a GDP per capita of $630. Your father knows that US GDP per capita is about $63,000. So he states that we are materially 100 times better off in the US than in the Caribbean nation. Number A, is your father's statement accurate? Number B, what are some examples of production not captured by GDP in both the United States and the Caribbean nation? Number C, would the exclusion of this type of production affect the measurement of Caribbean outputs more than in the United States output? Think about that. In summary, chapter in a nutshell. Gross domestic product, or GDP, measures a country's total income and expenditure. The four spending components of GDP include consumption, investment, government purchases, and net exports. Nominal GDP is measured using current prices. Real GDP is measured using the prices of a constant base year and is correlated and is corrected for inflation. GDP is the main indicator of a country's economic well-being, even though it is not perfect.